Let's move on now to physical sciences. And in this category, this year's winner is a professor in the Department of Inorganic and Physical Chemistry at the Indian Institute of Science, right here in Bengaluru. He got his BSc from the University of Madras, his MSc from the Bharatidasan University, and his PhD from the IIT Mumbai. His many recognitions include the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize and fellowships in three national academies, as well as the UK's Royal Society of Chemistry. To announce the prize, it is my pleasure to introduce Jury Chair Professor Srinivas Kulkarni. Professor Kulkarni is George Ellery Hale Professor of Astronomy and Planetary Sciences at Caltech. He's the former director of the famous Caltech Optical Observatories. His primary interests are the study of cosmic explosions, neutron stars, and developing new methodologies for astronomical research. He's known for the discovery of the first millisecond pulsar and the first brown dwarf. In 2017, he won the Dan David Prize for his contribution to the emerging field of time domain astronomy. He's also the recipient of the Alan T. Waterman Prize of the US National Science Foundation, the Helen B. Warner Award of the American Astronomical Society, and he's a fellow of the Royal Society of London. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Professor Srinivas Kulkarni.
The scope of the physical sciences panel is extremely large. It encompasses physics, chemistry, astronomy, geology, paleontology, and space sciences. In order to make a selection, I have help of an amazing jury panel, Professor Sachdev from Harvard University, who's actually in the audience, Dame Robinson from Oxford University, Ravi Shankara from Colorado State University, Professor Sood, also in the audience from ISC, and Rana Adhikari, professor at Caltech, also in the audience. I might add that Professor Adhikari is our youngest member and just won a breakthrough prize for a seminal contribution to the LIGO project and the discovery of the first coalescing black hole. So I've been the chair of this panel for 11 years, and it's getting increasingly very hard to choose amongst this wide range of topics. I'm very glad to announce the winner for 2019 in physical sciences is Professor G. Mugesh, professor at the Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru. His formal citation reads as follows: for his seminal work in the chemical synthesis of small molecules and nanomaterials for biomedical applications. His work has contributed to the understanding of the role of trace elements, selenium and iodine, in thyroid hormone activation and metabolism, and his research has led to major medical advances. Actually, it's quite easy to explain his work. Chemical reactions drive our body. The rate at which these reactions proceed obviously matters tremendously. Enzymes are chemicals which increase the rate of reactions. In lay terms, enzymes are catalysts. Perhaps the best known enzyme is amylase, which is the enzyme in our saliva. It is this enzyme that allows for speedy conversion of starch as you eat it to glucose, which ultimately provides the source of energy in your body. Our body is in trouble when cells can no longer synthesize enzymes. Professor Mugesh and his group have devised artificial enzymes which are functionally equivalent to natural enzymes. They're able to do this for certain classes of enzymes, namely in which are tied to trace elements, iodine and selenium, which play a critical role. and they can, these enzymes, they're synthesized, are amazing. They only about 300 atoms. In contrast, the enzymes we produce in our body is about 83,000 or 100,000. They're now experimenting with artificial enzymes based on surface reactions or nanozymes. However, designing artificial enzymes is one thing, but in order to make these enzymes useful, you have to insert them into the cell. It's not sufficient to just make them in the laboratory. And for this, Professor Mugesh and his group came up with a very clever solution of using halogen bonding by which the enzymes can now, in fact, be sent to the into the cells. Taken together, these two developments are expected to lead to major medical advances. Congratulations, Dr. Mugesh.
Thank you, Professor Kulkarni. And here are some thoughts from Professor Mugesh about using chemistry in biology.
Small molecules and nanomaterials have tremendous applications in biomedical research. My work involves the development of small molecules and nanomaterials that can regulate the redox signaling in human cells. I am G. Mugesh. I am a chemical biologist. Science is always in my mind. It has been a difficult journey. When I completed my master's, I wanted to do a PhD. And I decided to go to IIT Bombay. I did not tell my parents. After I joined the PhD program, I called my parents and told them that I'm going to stay in Bombay to do PhD. What drives me each day is to learn new things in area which is completely new to me. The curiosity to get into newer areas helps to get into much more challenging problems.
Please join me in welcoming on stage Professor G. Mugesh. May I request Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan and Professor Kulkarni to join in the presentation. And may I request Professor Amartya Sen to present the Infosys Prize in Physical Sciences to Professor G. Mugesh. Thank you, Mr. Gopalakrishnan. Professor Mugesh, a few words, please.
Good evening to all of you. And coming from a family of farmers, it's overwhelming for me to come to this stage. I thank the Infosys Science Foundation, the trustees, and the entire jury for selecting me to this prestigious award. I'm delighted to receive this. I thank the Indian Institute of Science, which provides the freedom to work on areas that are important. And I also thank the Department of Inorganic and Physical Chemistry and the Division of Chemical Sciences, which allowed me to work at the interface of chemistry and biology. I thank all my colleagues. Many of them are here. And I also thank the students involved in the work, taking challenging problems. And sometimes we don't get results immediately, keeping patience and keeping themselves motivated. Most of them are here, and I thank them for their hard work. And I would like to thank my family and my wife, Kavita, my sons. They are here, and for their constant support, and that was required to carry out this work. And thank you all.
Thank you, Professor Mugesh.